Today is July 26, 2021. There are more than a dozen different MS treatments on the market today, but can we already cure MS? The answer to that question might surprise you. I love this MS blog, run by a team of fantastic MS experts, professors, neurologists, immunologists, patients, etc. If you want to learn more about MS, then I highly recommend following this very active blog. Recently, Professor of Neurology Gavin Giovannoni, or Prof. G as he's called on the blog, wrote several posts about curing MS. The topographical model of MS that I talked about in the previous video helped me understand what he writes. Go and check out that video if you haven't seen it yet. In short, the model is a pool, and it's shallow on the left and gets deeper all the way to the right. The depth of the water in the pool represents a functional reserve of our CNS, the central nervous system. Functional reserve is our nervous system's ability to deal with damage. Nerve damage due to inflammation causes lesions in the CNS. In this model, lesions are represented by stalagmites arising from the bottom of the pool. The surface of the water is referred to as a clinical threshold. When a stalagmite breaks through the water surface, it causes noticeable symptoms. This model helps us to understand the post of Prof. G. He writes, "You may be cured of your MS, but still have worsening or progressive disease. All currently available MS drugs try to prevent neuroinflammation. They aim to minimize the number of new lesions that occur. There is a group of really potent MS treatments, so-called IRTs, immune reconstitution therapies. These therapies, they try to reset the immune system. I'm talking about cladribine, mavenclad, alemtuzumab, lemtrada, and HSCT. It's a high-dose chemotherapy followed by a blood stem cell rescue. These are all short course treatments, meaning that you don't have to take them for decennia, and these treatments could potentially prevent future inflammation from occurring. Maybe even forever. But Prof. G writes, even if you prevent all future inflammation, you might still have worsening disease. So how is that possible? To explain, let's have a look at our model. For a typical person who has had MS for a couple of years, the model might look like this. At this point, the person has one lesion that crosses the clinical threshold. This one here in the cerebellum. Due to this lesion, our patient might have some problems with his balance. There are 8 more lesions, but since they are all submerged, they don't cause any noticeable symptoms. Now, let's say we administer a treatment that completely prevents any new lesions from occurring. Over time, however, the water level will go down due to neurodegeneration. In people with a neurodegenerative disease such as MS, the rate of neurodegeneration or brain volume loss is faster. Prof. G calls this premature aging. But regardless of MS, neurodegeneration will happen at some rate to everyone. Our brain starts to degenerate, to shrink very slowly around the age of 40, and as we get older, this rate increases. In our pool, the reduction of functional reserve means that the water level goes down. Once this declining water level reveals underlying damage, the patient will experience a noticeable symptom. So as our person with MS gets older, the amount of water in the pool will decrease, revealing older damage. These old lesions now start to cause symptoms. Like this one here in the optic nerve, vision might get worse. Or this one here in the cerebral hemispheres, which might cause cognitive problems. The further the water level drops, the more symptoms might occur. So it seems like completely stopping new MS activity from occurring won't stop disease progression. Don't get me wrong, it is fantastic if you can completely stop MS activity. No new lesions, that's awesome. But it won't completely cure MS. Not only will existing damage never get entirely better, completely new symptoms might even arise over time. But what if we could stop MS inflammation directly after the first attack? The first attack in MS is called a CIS, a clinically isolated syndrome. In our pool model, it would be the first time that one or more lesions, stalagmites, rise above the water surface. What often happens is that after the acute inflammation subsides, the stalagmite recedes again below the surface, meaning that the symptom that it causes is no longer noticeable. What if we would give a person with a CIS an IRT, cladribine, alemtuzumab, or HSCT right after this first attack? New lesions might never occur anymore, and neurodegeneration due to aging might not cause any new symptoms. In this case, did we cure MS? And at what cost? I think we can all agree that treating MS effectively early on is very beneficial. But deciding on this is super difficult. As a patient, you might not feel too bad during the first years of your disease. At that point, would you consider a treatment that possibly has severe side effects? Maybe you would overtreat your MS and take unnecessary risks. I think it would be very helpful if your treating neurologist would help you weigh the benefits of early treatment to your future self, as it were, versus the possible side effects of these treatments at this moment. Prof. G on MS blog mentioned the same. I'm curious what other neurologists think about this. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye! Dear Dr. Bosser, my name is Bram Platel. I'm a researcher, an MS patient, and founder of Stichting MS in Beeld.